Hello there, it's Jay here from Jay's Vintage Junk, and as you may have noticed, I've not made any videos for a couple of weeks, and the reason behind that is, well, I'll show you now. It's this. Now, you may recall a few months ago I did a video showing my attic and the utter mess that was up there, and you couldn't find anything. It was just basically a storeroom. Well, in my spare time, when I've not been working over the last few weeks, I've put this together. So I plasterboarded all the walls. I've still got a little bit to do. I've still got some an edging to go around here just to finish that off, but yeah, I installed, well, me and a friend installed that skylight. I plasterboarded all the walls, which wasn't a fun task in a room this shape. I painted the beams, I put a carpet down, and made this workbench. As you can see, I've got a fair old selection of my vintage computers out that I can actually use there. As well as, this was actually one of my old office computers, which I didn't need anymore, but we have a PC up here, so I can get online and do anything online I need to do. We have some more space for joysticks, AV cables, anything else like that I need for up here. That's my little tool cupboard for up here. Some workbench space. I plan to have a couple of vintage PCs on the top here, as well as my PC for doing things on. So I've got a couple of old 486s. I might get a nice little 486 unit to go in that spot there. I might even get a Mac out. I might even dig an old Mac out and stick a Mac on here as well. I don't know yet. We've got my 6128. These are all in order of what computers I had first, really. First computer, proper computer I had at home was an Amstrad 6128, like this one. Not this one, but one very similar. After that, I got a C64, like that. After that, I got an Amiga. Actually, it was an Amiga 500 Plus, and then I got a 1200, but for space reasons, at the moment, I've just stuck this. I've got an Amiga 600 here. And then, of course, we've got my Dragon 32. All set up to play from CD, which is quite nice. And then we've got, obviously, the Amstrad has its own monitor. What I plan to do, the monitor that's on the PC there, we'll work on both, to be fair. It's got AV inputs as well. It's an old telly. So I can connect the Amstrad up to the LCD monitor if I want colour. But if otherwise, it's got its own little green screen on it. I have got a 14-inch colour for it, but unfortunately with the slope of the roof, it don't leave any space on the workbench for it. So for the moment, I'll stick with that green screen. We've got my C64C with a couple of disk drives. That's the monitor for it there, and that monitor is shared with the Amiga 600. I know it's not a very big monitor, but to be honest, the picture on the composite input's really, really good on it. So both them two computers, I have to swap the audio and video over at the moment, but I might make a little switcher for that. So them two are currently running off that monitor there, and this is really, really cool. It needs a clean, but while I was finding all my stuff, I dug this out. This is, I think Ashens, on one of his videos, did a review of this thing. They were Sega, I don't know, they were Master System Mega Drive compatible. But the weird thing about them was, they had two joystick cables coming out of them. The idea being that you could put this in player 1 and player 2 on your console or on your computer. You use the one joystick, and with this switch there, switch between player 1 and player 2. So what I've done is I've got one in the C64 and one in the Amiga. So I've got the one joystick hooked up, If I want to play a C64 games, I have it that way, and it works on the C64. I don't have to unplug anything. I just click it that way, and it runs on the Amiga. It plays as the joystick on the Amiga, which I thought was quite cool. And it's not actually a bad joystick. I mean, it's not brilliant, but I've been messing about with it, and it seems quite nice. I'll give it a proper clean and a restore, I think, because it's filthy, but it works nicely enough. And then, yes, we've got the Dragon 32 with its means of loading software, because I've got it set up so I can load software off CD on the CD32, and it's currently using that for its monitor. This is an old video player. It's out of a archive library, so it. No tuner in it, you could put a tape in it and see what's on the tape. That was the idea of that, but it's got composite and audio input on it. So I've got that hooked up to the Dragon as its monitor. What I will do, this is just a little brief overview of showing you what I've been up to and why I've not been making YouTube videos. I'm going to do some separate videos on all these computers, I think. I'm going to do one on the Dragon and showing how I use a computer like that one to burn a audio disc and run it on the Dragon there. I might do something on the Amiga. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with this Amiga up to now. I've got this 600 set up, but I've got 500 pluses, and I've got 500 plus or a 500, and I've got a couple of 1200s. I've only got enough room up here to have one Amiga set up, so I'm not sure whether I'm going to stick with this 600 or put a 1200 there or what yet. But if I stick with this 600, then no doubt I'll do a video on fitting a solid state hard drive to it, because at the moment I'm just running that off discs. I've got thousands of Amiga discs, and amazingly enough, from what I've been trying over the last day, most of them still seem to work okay despite being up here for like 20 years. So yeah, that's my the Amiga I'm using at the moment. C64 again, about as simple as you can get. I've got lots and lots of software for that on disc, so I probably won't, until I've actually gone through all the software that I've got, I probably won't do anything on that. But here's my my Amstrad. As you can see, I think I've done a video on this already. Yeah, I'm pretty certain I have. It uses a 3.5 inch PC drive, which is modified, and I will do a video on getting software off the internet using the software I have on that PC and getting it to run on this Amstrad here. So we'll probably do a nice video about that. I've got lots of up and coming projects to do up here. The whole reason of making this is that I didn't have anywhere I could really set a project up and do some proper videos. So yeah, that's why I've done this little exercise. So hopefully, now I've got all this storage space, I'm thinking about probably that monitor that I showed in a previous video I raked out of a skip's going to go on that wall there. I might have my PlayStation and my Xbox up here, so I can be out of the way if I want to do any gaming. I'm not a big gamer, but I got that old Xbox the other day and I've been messing about with that. I've got a few games for it I got for very little. So I'm going to soft mod it so I can run all the old SNES and NES games and things like that on it. That's a little monitor that I dug out of the cellar. That'll be used with one of my computers. I'm not sure which one yet. That's a brilliant little monitor. Little TV with it's a bit filthy, but as you can see at the back, it's got mono audio and composite input on it. Only problem I've got with this one, which I have found, is to switch it into AV mode, you need the remote control, and I haven't got the remote control for it. So I can either find a way of tricking it and setting it permanently into AV mode, or I'll have to see if I can find a remote for it. But it's got a really nice strong tube in it, really bright picture, so I'm not throwing it away just for that, and it'll work really nicely up here. Well, I think I'm going to leave it at that for now, so at least you can see I'll spin round on my nice spinny chair. There we go. you can see what I've been up to over the last few weeks. So I will leave it at that for now. So thanks for watching and goodbye.